For the Grizzlies, averaging 76 points a game, Bob. Their point guard's terrific. Top five in the country in assists. He's Khalif Elder. He wears number 20. He is but a sophomore. And for Michigan State, you mentioned the three-headed monster. This team averages 75 points a game. Brent Forbes still playing with a bit of a cast, but his shooting may be significant tonight. Tom Izzo with 474 wins and counting and 17 straight NCAA appearances last year to the Elite Eight. Key player got hurt, could have gone further. And Greg Campy, season number 31, 523 wins, and he was telling us prior to the game, he and Izzo go back, well, maybe 30 years.
Yeah, remarkable. You're not going to see that very often. Two guys on each bench with 51 combined years between them at the same schools. Remarkable and very great winning traditions.
Gavin Schilling will jump for Michigan State against Corey Petros of Oakland. Michigan State home white, the black uniforms to the Grizzlies. Michigan State hoping to get the opening tip and dunk. Unable to do so despite the way it looked in shoot-around today.
Easier when there's nobody else on the other side out there.
Always looks better in practice, doesn't it? No Travis Bader this year, but we welcome him watching from Paris, France, early in the morning as he is key observer to watch his former Grizzlies team. On the baseline, nice soft hook by Tommy McHugh, number 23, is a forward from Saginaw, Michigan. There are many Michigan products on both sides tonight, and in fact, some Lansing kids on both sides as well.
Oakland foul on 23, Tommy McHugh.
McHugh, after the field goal, picks up a personal foul.
Take a look at the nice touch on the baseline.
And back to live action, Trice knocks down to three. He's shooting it at 41%.
This is where they can be so devastating in the open floor.
Just about everybody on this team getting a touch on this possession.
They threw seven passes in 9 seconds on that possession.
And Dawson fouled. Brandon Dawson with 18 rebounds against Notre Dame the other night in an overtime loss.
Not his forte, just 41% from the free throw line.
Bob, it's interesting. Both teams shoot the ball well inside, very well from the outside. But the free throw shooting on both sides is poor.
Michigan State's was really poor early in the year. They've been getting better of late, but missed opportunity there. You missed two free throws, it's like a turnover.
So ball back to the Grizzlies. Inside Petros, stripped away. Here comes Brent Forbes, the Cleveland State transfer. Intended for Dawson, now in the hands of Dawson.
That's where he has really come on of late. You know, when you're sick and you miss some time early, it shows that he missed a lot of chippies early. Now he's starting to get those inside shots to go down. Nice touch on that one off the window.
And with that, he's shooting roughly 51% from the floor. Oakland had an open man in the corner. Didn't find Felder. It's into Petros. Nice soft baby hook. And we were talking to Campy prior to the game, the Oakland coach. He said, you know, his field goal attempts aren't particularly large. It's because he's getting to the free throw line a great deal. Dawson off the bounce. And taken down by the Grizzlies. With uniforms in which the numbers are hard to pick up. As Felder drives to the basket.
Well, I'm glad you said that. Because quite honestly, I think that should be put in the rule book. The numerals have got to be outlined in a white or a lighter shade. That's what I... Because not only for us as announcers, although we're selfish, we only think of ourselves.
Sure.
But when you're playing a game and you're coming down the floor quickly in transition, you don't have time to examine. What is that? And frankly, you know, that's how guys find their defensive assignments a lot, by numbers.
Yeah, you'll see that with some teams in football. Boise State typically has numbers difficult to pick up. And with that blue field, numbers can mesh together. And that's really a challenge and maybe more of a challenge for the defense. Michigan State leading 5-4, opening minutes of the first half, and traveling called on the Oakland Grizzlies.
That's been a bit of a bugaboo for both these teams. They both make more turnovers per game than they create by about two, so that'll be a storyline to follow today. Michigan State negates it, though, with their great offensive rebounding, and Greg Campy told us that was a huge concern of his tonight.
And Tom Izzo was saying at shoot-around today, his team is getting healthier in terms of both injuries and just normal viruses and such, and so getting just about everybody back will be key for them as they get closer to conference play.
Oh, what a nifty pass there. Good block coming from the back, though, by Costello. Got a piece of that.
In transition, Trice with an opportunity back to Costello.
We have two very creative guards off the assist. Felder at one end made a beautiful pass, but the shot was blocked by that guy. Costello with a good, strong finish off the creative pass from Trice.
Well, and speaking of his defense, you had a chance to watch him defend Jahlil Okafor on opening night in that big tournament in Indianapolis. So what were your impressions?
Well, I mean, this is a front line for Tom Izzo that is getting better, and they already were kind of formidable. They blocked some shots. Offensively, they've come on of late. So, I think that Tom Izzo thinks he's got a special bunch here. He really does, and they're far from a finished product.
Leading in this game, 10-4. Trice.
Another nice pass.
To Dawson. Back to Trice. Foul called on the Grizzlies.
They do such a good job, Jim, of getting to spots, spreading the defense. Then they don't hold it, and if they can get you chasing them, well, now you're in all sorts of trouble. On plays like that, they go by you and draw a foul. If they miss, they get rebounds. Very good in the break.
Personal foul on Oakland's Dante Williams. Trice, three, left baseline, missed it. Costello tried to keep it alive.
Nice catch. That was a difficult pass to gather in.
Offense runs through this guy, Corey Petros. And saved by Williams.
This little guy's fascinating to me, Felder. He leads them in assists, blocks, steals, and there's a beautiful delivery there.
And he is all of 5'9". Not Petros, but Felder.
Felder leads them. He averages 5 rebounds a game, and he's 5'9".
Spent a lot of offseason working on his jumper. Offensive foul on Michigan State.
Spark foul on 20, Travis Trice.
It's on Travis Trice. 15-27 for the first half. Oakland campus, about 90 minutes away from Michigan State. Grizzlies will head to the airport after the game tonight and then fly out early tomorrow morning to Tucson, Arizona to face number 3, Wildcats. Greg Campy's resume not only includes his 31 years, but the fact he has 6 Summit League titles and he is the third longest at one school in Division I. Oakland head coach is been playing Michigan State for a long time. This is the second year of a 6-year arrangement in which 3 games are played at the Breslin Center and 3 at the Palace in Auburn Hills, and that's Oakland's home game.
And thinks it does so much for his program, obviously, with kids in this area. We heard his comments at the top of the show. He's telling his players, you dreamt about playing against these guys. Here's your chance.
Off the hands of Corey Petros. Oakland's third turnover, Michigan State with a single turnover. And both teams now hitting the bench. That's Lou Rawls, Nairn Jr., Tum Tum. Dawson rises and misses. Tum Tum got the Tum Tum nickname from the Three Ninjas movie. Mom loved the nickname for the character in the movie, and the grandfather loved Lou Rawls. Catch and shoot, Brent Forbes. It's what he does.
Yeah, that's what they do. In transition, that's their best offense, without question. certainly early in the season especially.
And his transfer, Bob, from Cleveland State to Michigan State, obviously plus side Michigan State, is a three. It's knocked down in the corner by Dante Williams. And what a loss it is for Cleveland State, as Gary Waters' team is struggling without Forbes' offense this year.
Take a look in transition. Look at the great spacing. Look how much ground they make you defend in a hurry. Getting corner to corner, and then at the other end, a nice pass on Williams, who has taken more and made more threes than anybody on this Oakland team. 40% shooter. One of those four guys we mentioned that shoot over 40% from the three-point line. Oakland City here. Oakland, rather, with a chance to take the lead.
Oakland last year had 147 threes from their sharpshooter, Travis Bader. It's a three against one. Valentine!
So good in transition. So comfortable.
Petros had to give it up, and that jumper from the outside, good by Max Hooper.
He's only a 35% three-point shooter.
And he's a great story. Started at Harvard, transferred to St. John's, finished up at St. John's. He's a graduate student.
Uh-oh, dangerous save
there. Now at Oakland, and he has 2 years of eligibility remaining. Three ball on the way for the lead. Good! Dante Williams, who has knocked down two of those.
Three-point shot, the great equalizer in college basketball. Third of the game already for Oakland.
And Oakland up 15-12. Grizzlies have never beaten Michigan State. Valentine with his equalizer tied at 15.
Well, that's the problem for Oakland. They're up against a team that'll match them three for three. In fact, they make a fragment more threes per game than Oakland does, 9.2 to 8.8.
Bob, if we get in a shootout, who's that favor?
I got to think that it's going to favor the Spartans, because somewhere there's going to be some misses in there. More shots, more rebounds, and they're the better rebounding team.
And a miss there, and Nairn Jr. down to Valentine. Quickly in the front court.
Nice.
And a kick to the corner. And Oakland doing a good job of making sure there wasn't a second chance. Campy likes this team. He thinks in a year it could be pretty special.
Like his teams of a few years back. NCAA tournament teams very much thinks it's the same recipe. They just need to let the cake bake, if you want to use the recipe analogy, with patience.
Heading to the 12-minute mark. Felder on the miss, and a foul coming up on Oakland, which would be team foul number 5, 2 on Michigan State. All right, no, Bob, you were worried about whether Oakland would extend this streak, and that 3 moments ago, in fact, a couple of series ago, now has them continuing their making of three-pointers dating back 25 years and change.
Eighth longest active streak in the country, and they ended any drama tonight in a hurry.
Speaking of threes,
that's too easy. I mean, if they do that, they got no chance. From 11, Tum-Tum Aaron. That was just as easy as could be. Pitch and catch there. Valentine, a good three-point shooter, almost 50% on the year.
Well, Greg Campy jokingly says there's quite a difference between the two coaches. You know, principally, we have a lot of the same values. We love the state of Michigan. We've never left it. But on offense, after a basket scored, we want to score as soon as possible. If somebody scores at Michigan State, Tom Izzo takes a moment of silence.
This one is how you run your fast break. Great spacing, good pass, authoritative finish by Clark. Right on the money by Valentine. Sparty by three. He's great. He is as universally respected and probably liked as any coach in the business. Usually you win as much as a guy like him, you make enemies by accident, but people, even his colleagues, seem to think the world of him. Great guy. I'd like to see him coach a game dressed up like that. Now you got some.
You know, I think if you're driving around at the time of Midnight Madness in East Lansing, you have nothing better to do.
You should be here.
Just to see what he's going to do. No offensive board so far for Michigan State, by the way, but seven rebounds. Williams has two threes this time. With his first miss, Michigan State home white and up by three. Spartans getting set for a number of home games after starting this season with 6 of 8 road appearances. Valentine step back.
It's a nice pace for Oakland right now. They don't want this game to be up in the 80s. They'd like to keep this thing in the 60s, maybe.
Petros running body to body against Gavin Schilling. Right hook, did it before. This time he didn't get the friendly roll. Out of bounds and a fresh 35 to Oakland. Tomorrow night on ESPNU, the undefeated Blue Devils look to build on a 113 straight non-conference win streak in Cameron, an inch closer to Coach K's 1,000th win. Number 2 Duke against Elon, part of Holiday Hoops, presented by K Jewelers. Petros with an offensive rebound. Williams will try another three. He has been white hot from there.
Sized it up, had all sorts of time off that offensive rebound.
Bested by 5, 3 4.
Of course, the problem for Oakland is after a made field goal, it often gives up another basket. Still just a 2-point game halfway through first half.
Got to take that transition away, even off make shots.
Drop down Petros. And we'll tie at 20.
Third field goal for Petros, making his presence felt early. Doing a nice job sealing the defender. You don't move till the ball's over your head there. Lock him on your hip. That's what an experienced player does, made it look easy.
Petros had 25 points, 8 rebounds, and a high-scoring loss to Iowa State. Dawson spinning to the goal. Pretty move.
Kinds of shots, as we said at the top, he was missing early in the year. He has come on of late.
You watch Michigan State shoot around today, and you talk to Spartans people, and they say these last two practices, lots of energy, a lot of smiles, kids with about the reported 500 pounds of weight off their shoulders because finals are over. Good time to play basketball, I think.
I don't think I've ever seen players more excited to go to practice than when finals were over.
Now that will change when the two-day practices take place in the holidays. Three and away is good. Denzel Valentine.
Well, we've got a lot of games, 42-38 late in the game. This one, we have already had 9 3-point field goals made.
To follow your point, we've had final scores, final team totals in the 40s, 30s, and last night Texas State in the 20s.
I think college basketball is trying to rediscover itself. Last year they tried some rule changes to get some offense. Another nice pass, but again, the good hands inside. Schilling.
That's Trice pulling up.
That's unusual for him, a 41% three-point shooter. That was wide right. But, you know, we're trying to figure out, I think, of the powers that be, what the game's going to be. They're talking about debating about widening that arc around the basket to try and take away some of those offensive fouls. Shortening the shot clock, perhaps.
I like that idea.
I like both those ideas, to be honest with you.
What do you think, go to the NBA, 24, second shot clock?
I wouldn't have a problem. The world is getting kind of all on that same page. Certainly, we can cut it down to into 35. There's so many possessions. Guys just dribble out of midcourt and let the shot clock run down.
Dawson missing and kept it alive.
Nice pass. Six threes already for Michigan State.
And those were the type of rebounds that Greg Campy, the Oakland coach, wanted to get tonight.
And those are the ones he cannot win if they don't get their share of those.
This is the biggest lead of our young game in the first half. Now Oakland slows it down to a crawl, under 10 to shoot. Felder rims a three, and three white-shirted bodies to go for the rebound. At the next whistle, which will be our television timeout, Oakland will send in three reinforcements, Michigan State two.
Blocked off his leg.
Yeah, good defense there, too.
There's a timeout on the floor.
Take a look here. This was right off of an Oakland score. And they let it come back a little bit too easily for Forbes. And then what a nice pass there by Dawson. Finding the shooter in the corner. Help Michigan State be up by six.
Timeout. Denzel Valentine limited to just 8 points on 3-6 shooting. Tonight, he already has nine, and he has looked terrific from the outside.
You know, it's impressive. Not only is he making shots from the perimeter, as you mentioned, perfect behind the arc, 3 3-point field goals for his 9 points, but he also has 3 assists. That makes it so tough to defend. Here he is tracking down a loose ball, hustle play, turns that into a three as well. 3 of 3 behind the arc for 9 points, 3 rebounds, 3 assists. Pretty good night for a lot of guys, and we are just not even 15 minutes into the game.
And for the season now, with his made threes, Bob, 28 for 55, slightly above 50%. Sparty's over here harassing us.
I know. That's all right. We like Sparty.
It's hard to concentrate. But
here's a stat Sparty will like. There have been, of all the baskets in the game, 9 for Oakland, 11 for Michigan State. Oakland has 9 assists. Michigan State has 9 on their
He
11.
Likes it.
It's a nice help, isn't it? He was impressed by that.
Thank you. Now Sparty's in our way. I'll have to look at the monitor. 28 for Michigan State, 24 for Oakland. Two possession game, like how it finished last year in the Palace. Brandon Dawson trying to take somebody off the dribble. And he is having a pretty good first half with 6.
Yeah, 3 field goals. And again, those are the kind of shots that are so important to their offense. He gives them that great little mid-range presence around the bucket, pull-up shots in the lane, looking very confident. Tough shot.
Oakland basket by 23, Tommy McCune.
Tommy McCune started the game with a first field goal for Oakland.
Once he drove, they had 3 guys coming. I was waiting for him to kick it out, but he took them all on. There's that mid-range shot we just talked about.
Basket by
Dawson now 4 for 8 from the floor. Six-point game in favor of Michigan State. McCune working inside again. Left it short. Here come the Spartans. Blocked! Williams got up and blocked it. It stays in play for Michigan State. Here's Costello. We're not missing much in the first half, Bob.
Well, got to get a hand up there a little bit. Daniels was a little upset because McCune went to the basket and again drew a double team. He was wide open in the corner. You're going to pull that defense in the lane. You got to find shooters. It affects your defensive energy when the ball's not getting moved around.
Grizzlies have not been to the free throw line yet. We played 16 minutes. Michigan State just 3 tries, making 1.
It's going to be over the back on Costello.
Spartan foul on 10, Matt Costello. His first, his third.
Terrific block in transition there by Williams. Great hustle.
0 Clark and 3.
Although it's kind of an awkward shot. The ball almost bounced away from Forbes. He did well to resecure possession, but he probably couldn't get it quite up to the rim as strongly as he wanted to.
You know, at one point Oakland was tied in the first half, now trailing by 8. Is there any fear about this getting away from them here?
They're going to have to find. They're really taking some ill-advised shots. That was a Daniels got a little lucky there. A bailout. That was a tough shot.
Spartan foul number 3. Alvin Ellis. His first.
Yes, Brendan, there have been a bunch of surprises to this point. I thought the biggest one, the 2 biggest, were Michigan's back-to-back losses, both at home.
Yeah, there's a lot of surprising results going on around the country. Army goes out and beats USC. Couldn't beat Navy, unfortunately for them, but managed to beat USC on the hardwood. You know, when you think about upsets, you think about three-point shooting. We'll talk about those numbers in a minute.
The U brings you coverage of the NCAA Division III Football Championship. Wisconsin Whitewater and Mount Union. NCAA Division III Football Championship is presented by Northwestern Mutual, Friday at 7 on ESPNU and watch ESPN. I was witness yesterday on ESPN3 to Mount Union's win over Wesley in the semis, in which Mount Union led 70-0 in the third quarter in evenly matched teams. At least prior to the game, it was billed as that.
It'll give you a little momentum going into the championship game, I would think.
Kevin Burke is their quarterback, threw for 7 touchdowns yesterday, and he can win the Heisman equivalent being the Gagliardi Trophy when it's announced later this week. Back here, 8-point difference. Oakland trying to get inside. Petros defended by Costello. Grizzlies now 11 of 26 from the floor.
Talked about three-point shooting being equalized. Oakland shooting it pretty well, 40% behind the three-point line. They made 4, but they're going to have to find some way to get some stops. Michigan State shooting 54%, and that's only going to add to it.
Well, they worked that weave out front, and they lost the inside scorer in Costello.
He's having a big first half. 3 field goals, 7 points.
And this is an 8-0 Michigan State run, their largest lead now at 10. Oakland needs to answer with some offense. Petros with a rebound. Third opportunity and a foul call, and that'll be free throws as Terry Weimer blows the whistle.
Spartan foul on 0. Marvin Clark, his first, the team's 5th.
Marvin Clark picks up the personal foul, team foul, number 5 on Michigan State.
Ralph Hill shooting 2 free throws.
This is Ralph Hill, another one of the graduates on this Oakland roster. He's entered into the MBA program at the university.
Tom Izzo, by the way, telling us before the game, Javon Bess, who is going to be a difference maker probably for this team, probably could play tonight if he really desperately needed him to, but they're being very safe, and that will be a big difference, because early in the year, those 3 losses were games they ran out of gas late, and they certainly on the perimeter could use another guy. Bess could be an impact player.
Said they were having difficulty just scrimmaging, finding enough healthy bodies at one point. By the way, Oakland at the free throw line, moments ago for the first time in this game.
And, you know, it's a game that's designed for some runs because Michigan State does such a good job in running off of misses that if Oakland can put a couple of baskets together, get to the line, set their defense up, this gives them the best chance to get some stops.
Oakland's bench has done the majority of the scoring, outscoring the Spartans by 9. Here's Clark, and held up. Williams held him up. Michigan State keeps possession, shot clock down to 9, and now the arrow
somebody
flips the other way.
Somebody's got to tell Trice, because he's walking like he's going for a bus at the other end of the court.
He was not in a prevent defense off of this shot.
I think he thought they called a foul, or there was a turnover and a travel, but now he's back in play.
9 to shoot it. Clark got a look. He knocked those down in practice too, Bob.
They just keep firing behind the arc. 7 made threes. Best NCAA percentage three-point team in the country, and you see why tonight.
Back the other way, a 3 on the way, badly missed by Daniels.
Not a good shot there. That looked like a freshman shot.
Tum Tum with a kick. And the defense for Oakland's not working.
The three-point party continues, and the fans here enjoying it.
Well, the fans here, too, aren't normal spectators because of the fact that
I think
the
they
kids
resent
have,
that, if you call
well,
it.
Usual spectators. That's a better word, thank you. Yes, I noticed a couple of chagrined people over there. I apologize to them immediately. Anyway, school's out, so a lot of people that don't get a chance to see Michigan State have gobbled up the tickets. It's officially sellout, although there'll be some empty seats tonight at Breslin.
Good crowd, though, absolutely, for a semester break game.
Hey, think about it. People that don't get a chance to ordinarily see the team, that's a big deal.
Oh, what a smart play that was.
This is 5-2.
And now they're starting to get a little discouraged. You start missing shots, takes away from that energy on the defensive end, and they haven't been exactly lights out on the defensive end to begin with.
Nope. Michigan State with a use-it-or-lose-it timeout. We'll use it with 1:17 remaining here in the first half.
ESPN's exclusive presentation of college basketball is brought to you by Dish. Only the Hopper from Dish gives you the power to watch all your live and recorded TV anywhere.
Jim Barber and the former head coach, Bob Valvano. This is outside the Breslin Center. And now back indoors. In part, an alumni band participating tonight. The students having vacated the premises for a few weeks.
Well, you can tell when coaches kind of have a good feel about their team. And Tom Izzo has a good feel about this team. He thinks that, you know, like a lot of guys who love to teach, kind of eager to get to those two-a-days during the semester break and see how much improvement they can make. He's never afraid to play the hardest, very difficult schedule early. In fact, it's unbelievable. Since 98, of all the teams that have been to the Final Four, they played 188 ranked teams. The second most team is North Carolina, 19 fewer. That's unbelievable.
Steal an open court. Layup is good. Nice play by Khalil Felder. So let's follow your point. Why don't other teams, especially the higher division type teams, play a tougher schedule?
You know, that's a really good question. I think it's a philosophical thing. Nice pick and roll there. Boy, what a big half he's had of Costello. I mean, that's a legitimate question. And guys get it done both ways. You know, they've teased Jim Boeheim for years about you can't pry him out of New York until January 1st, and he's done all right for himself. And then Tom Izzo, you get the feeling to play anybody, any place, any time.
Early part of the season playing Duke, of all people, at Bankers Life in Indianapolis. Under 10 to shoot, winding down the first half. Michigan State has controlled the last 10 minutes. And Petros to the line, and Costello over the back with a foul. That makes the resume even more impressive, the fact that they will body up against some of the best in the country. 8-time National Coach of the Year, 17 straight NCAA appearances. Won the title in Indianapolis, 2000. Final Four is in Indy this year.
He's always had a big picture, which is, he doesn't have to really worry about his overall strength of schedule. He's in one of the power leagues, of course. You take a look at all the conference championships. He just figures this is going to help his team get better as they go forward. That's the bottom line for him, and he's managed to do it very, very effectively. Some guys are not that comfortable doing that early.
Really pays off when you get to the one-and-done time in the NCAA tournament. Final seconds, first half. Michigan State by 13. Gonna have to shoot it. First half over. Spartans shoot over 50% from the three-point line and are leading at the break 44-31. Now let's join Brendan Fitzgerald and Dino Gaudio in the studio for the halftime report. And welcome back to East Lansing. Streets are quiet tonight. Most of the holiday shopping has been done for the most part. It's all part of Holiday Hoops, presented by K Jewelers. 44-31 our score. I'm Jim Barber. This is Bob Valvano, the former head coach. All right, first half, Michigan State shoots 7-11 from the three. Is it bad defense or great offense?
It's a combination of both. I mean, this is not known as a great defensive team in Oakland, but boy, this Michigan State team has firepower at a lot of positions, and when they get it going like they did tonight, they can put a big number up in a hurry. Take a look. It all starts behind the arc, and they have different guys doing it. Valentine there had 3 three-pointers in the first half. What a terrific pass that time by Dawson to find the open man in the corner. They moved the ball so well, Michigan State. 15 assists on 18 field goals. You see Clark steps up. He knocks down a three. And then this is where they get some great threes also in transition. Tum Tum with a nice kick out and the knockdown by Trice. Great ball movement. Great spacing. And if you're Oakland and you have any aspirations of an upset, you can't come in here and give up 60% field goal shooting and get out shot behind the line 7-4. Too much offense by Michigan State.
Let's go back to the three-headed monster in the first half and how they played, Bob. 23 of Michigan State's first half points of 44. Doing what they do. And look at that, not just points, but look how many other things. Three assists for Trice, three rebounds for Valentine. They're getting it done across the board. They've got a lot of firepower, this team, and they've certainly hit on all cylinders in that first half.
Khalil Felder just gave up the ball to Williams, who knocked down in the first half three threes. But Felder has struggled to shoot the ball 1 of 6.
That's too easy again.
Schilling, basket and one to start the second half. For Michigan State, and more of the same, getting in transition and scoring.
I mean, you've got to at least make them work a little bit. Look how long before they never really even did challenge the ball. Trice could come down and just glance at the whole court. You got big guys who can run, and this team has that. They're going to get some easy ones. That time, Schilling.
First points of the game for Gavin Schilling, and now seven different Spartans have scored. Largest lead, Michigan State by 15.
They've had four different guys have double-doubles this year for Michigan State. Costello, Dawson, Schilling, and Valentine.
Well done there to Dante Williams, who's been able to show he can score from the outside and also leap on the interior. Williams with 13 to lead Oakland in scoring. He averages 10.
Set play, back screen. They cleared out the help. There's nobody there, and they just lobbed it up, and Valentine made it look easy.
This is the gauntlet in terms of a schedule for Oakland. Tonight, Michigan State, then at Arizona, ranked third in the country and undefeated. That will be on Tuesday. We'll also see Clemson down the road and Pitt.
Spectacular shot by Felder, who was awfully quiet in the first half.
Dawson waves at that one. Let's go back to Oakland's field goal moments ago.
The alley-oop, and then at the other end there you see they brought the high post man up, cleared all the help out of the weak side, and no communication. Too easy. Valentine makes him pay.
It's interesting, in the first half, Bob, 12 made field goals for Oakland, 10 were assisted, 18 made baskets for Michigan State, and 15 were assisted.
Yeah, that, offensively, Oakland has given a decent account of themselves against this usually stubborn Michigan State defense. They're just getting swamped offensively. Here they go again.
Dawson inside, you won't stop him there. Especially with a deep catch like that.
One of the problems is somebody's got to pick up the ball sooner. They're allowing the ball to come unfettered until it's already inside the three-point line. This team passes too well to allow that.
Tonight's matchup, the Horizon League versus the Big Ten. Monday night, that's tomorrow night, ESPNU undefeated Duke. Trying to make it 113 wins in a row against non-conference teams in Cameron Indoor Stadium. Coach K is getting close to 1,000 wins. Duke and Elion. It's part of Holiday Hoops presented by K Jewelers. You had a chance to see Duke against Michigan State. What were your thoughts?
I thought they were incredibly impressive. If Kentucky weren't so dazzling that night and Kentucky overwhelmed Kansas, you'd have walked out buzzing about Duke. I mean, that's just... I don't know who on their schedule they're going to be able to beat in that conference, that very competitive conference, if they allow the ball that easily up the floor. I know there aren't many teams that run as well as Michigan State, but still, that's too simple.
Michigan State now with 19 points in transition. It's more than a third of the offense.
Lazy pass. Look at Trice, how smart. Anticipated that the whole time.
And they've got numbers, and Forbes has got an open look.
Wow. Very sharp. You know, coaches wonder sometimes in the first game out of exams how sharp the team's going to be. This team's looking sharp tonight. 20-point lead.
Inside the Oakland huddle, Tommy McCune, who stars for the Grizzlies,
lost his mom this summer to lung cancer. And last month versus Western Michigan, the team honored her before the game with a moment of silence. And Tommy went out and had a career-high 27 that night. He went 3-for-3 beyond the arc. And this for a guy that shot just 18% from the arc a year ago. Amazing night for Tommy McCune, who I'm sure still has his thoughts of his late mom as we approach the holidays.
Certainly anybody, and that's probably 99% of our viewing audience, has lost someone dear to them because of cancer, knows that pain. And he has reacted very well under the adversity, according to Greg Campy, who said, you know, sometimes it takes things like that to make guys kind of take that next step in their maturity, and that's what they're looking for out of him. And he certainly is a guy with a lot of skills and a lot of tools.
And you were in New York where they paid tribute to your brother in the Jimmy V Classic, and I suppose that there are so many reminders during the course of the year with that great foundation about the loss of somebody who was special to you.
What a great doubleheader at Villanova and Illinois and Louisville and Indiana. Going into the game, the teams were 29-2 combined, so it was great basketball, and then the speech and the stories and people recommitting themselves to finding a cure for this terrible disease. Yeah, it was a very special night, and it had been a very special Jimmy V week.
Now for Oakland, it's one and out. Long lead pass to Travis Trice. Well, Michigan State can't afford to play up tempo here because that's where a lot of the field goals are coming from.
Just overwhelming. 21 fast break points to 5, Michigan State doing some job in transition.
And Oakland shooting not up to par here in the second half. For the game now 14 of 37. That's under 40%.
There goes McCune on the foul.
And Tommy should be going to the free throw line to shoot twice on the foul on Dawson.
Talk about Michigan State's defense, though. We talked about their shooting all night. Their defense has been uncanny in the last 7 games. They've given up just 35% shooting from the field and 26% shooting behind the three-point line. So kind of lost in all this hot perimeter shooting for Michigan State is how good they've been defensively.
And it's the reason they fare so well in the Big Ten Conference. Tom Izzo averaging 12 league wins a year. Now they play 18 in the conference. They used to play 16. That makes that number even more remarkable. And they've got a chance to find their way to Indianapolis for the Final Four. In fact, the Spartans have been overshadowed a lot by conversation centering around Wisconsin. Valentine.
What versatility in his game, huh? Makes the 3 open threes in the first half. That time off the bounce for the mid-range shot. He has 3 assists in the game as well.
He's a co-captain on this team, and Corey Petros continues to work as hard as anybody, and he will have an and-one opportunity. Upon our return, it is 57-39 Michigan State. This is the nightcap of college basketball on ESPNU. Good look at the Michigan State Football Center. Mark D'Antonio's team headed to a major bowl after a sparkling year that was dented just twice by Oregon and Ohio State, both of which made the college football playoff. Bob Valvano, Jim Barber back here with Tom Izzo. We'll start conference play shortly with 221 league wins. That's fourth best behind Bob Knight, Gene Cady, and Ward Lambert.
That's some heady company there, and he looks like he's far from finished. Another strong season on tap for Tom Izzo's bunch this year.
He will be 60 years of age on January 30th. Doesn't look it, though, does he?
His energy. And it's funny because when we talked about Mike Krzyzewski before in Duke, it's kind of the same deal. It's just incredible. They just seem to get better. You know, they just, their energy level stays as high as ever, and they just continue to relate to kids and be innovative. It's remarkable to see.
I think that's the most amazing thing. As they grow older and the kids, as they turn rosters over, are younger,
in most instances, and they still have that rapport. Of course, they win, and that helps.
That's where I think working with the national team helped Coach K a lot.
Sure. Feeding Costello, a Michigan State turnover. There haven't been many tonight, just seven.
Oakland's made just seven also. See the difference. Look at the difference in the three-point shots for Oakland, though, as opposed to Michigan State. Did you see the challenge on that shot?
Yes.
That was a very difficult opportunity there.
Yep, two players contesting that shot.
Now, UB Brown once had, take a look at this. Look at that. Hand in the face, great challenge. 40% difference, according to Coach Brown, in an NBA season. He charted every shot from a challenge shot to an open shot. Think about that. The best players in the world, it affects them like that.
A lot of statistics in this game, and that perhaps is the most revealing. Clark on the drive, got his own miss, and he'll step to the free throw line. Marvin Clark Jr. One time, Tom Izzo referred to him as a poor man's Brandon Dawson.
Look at the second effort. Misses the shot. Makes the first one to the ball. And turns it into a second chance opportunity. And rebounding is so important to this team. Since Tom Izzo's been here, they have out-rebounded opponents 512 out of 664 games, which makes 77% of the time. That's got to be a key part of the recipe for success for him.
Well, if you attend some of his practices, and I have in the past, I mean, they are physical, get-after-type practices. So they practice what they preach, and typically some of the games probably are easier than the practices. Seems like all the great ones have practices that are very challenging, and the games become a little simpler.
It's going to be an offensive foul here. Frustration now starting to set in a bit.
Greg Campy with words for the outside official in that play, Lewis Garrison.
Petros gets called for the foul. I believe that's four on him.
And it's going to be very difficult to play without him. He is a central figure in this offense. If you're just joining us, Michigan State's three-point shooting, the difference in this game is the Spartans try to continue their unbeaten win streak against the Oakland Grizzlies.
With Petros out, they try and go right inside, but good, that's a good shot. I mean, Costello got a great look, couldn't get it to go down.
By the way, that's Matt Costello's first miss of the night after five makes. Four Michigan State Spartans in double figures already.
Oh, my goodness, had that gone in, that would have been... I mean, even the Michigan State fans might have wanted to see that go in.
Sure.
I've not seen one to go bank off the top and go in like that.
When you play that game of horse, that's one of those you call and say, go ahead.
I just concede the letter. Take a look at the numbers. Wow. Michigan State 8 for 12 behind the three-point line. And they're getting great three-point shots right out of their offense. They space the floor so well and very unselfish, the ball movement.
Right now, Matt Costello and Tom Izzo are having a conversation. Matt pulled out. Gavin Schilling is back in. I imagine Tom allows some give and take, but not a great deal of it.
Well, during practice, though, that's the one thing. I wish fans could do what we have the opportunity to do, watch these guys in practice. It's extraordinary, the teaching and the atmosphere they generate. Felder's been quiet tonight.
Blocked by Brendan Dawson. And a foul coming up on Dawson.
Let's take a look. Well, if it was a foul, it was out of our picture there.
Seemed like it was a late whistle.
Well, the only thing I can think is he hit him with his body down low, because up top, that was about as clean as you can get. Felder's so important to this team, and now especially more so with Petros out. He has struggled tonight. Averages just under 16 a game. That's just his fifth point. He's the leader in assists, steals, free throw attempts. So he's been a little quiet this evening.
He got a chance to play in the Moneyball Pro-Am League during the summer and found himself trying to score on Draymond Green, who started at Michigan State. I don't think he scored, but he did get fouled. And he said, I had to take it to the big guy. I had to send a message.
Well, if he gets fouled, he'll make you pay. He's an 84% free throw shooter.
Travis tries again with an open look. Boom!
Marvin Clark.
What's his wingspan?
Oh, my. It's one of those you could just see it coming. As the shot hit the rim, he was timing his steps. Nobody blocked him out. More reason for celebration and more reason for that shooting percentage to stay very high for Michigan State.
Spartans won a number of minutes at the start of this game without an offensive rebound. That has changed rather dramatically. Catch and shoot three, rims in and out by McCune.
Watch the spacing they get in transition. Look how much room everybody has to operate. They'll swing the ball from side to side. Well, now Tom Izzo calling a set. But, boy, I just love how they make you so quickly get on your heels defensively.
It's like everybody's got their own zone out there.
That's a nice pass by Trice.
Second opportunity for Schilling. He'll have to make them from the free throw line. But moments ago, Michigan State highlight. Dawson with the jam, or Clark with the jam. And it's worth another look. Spartans by 17. Busy time for the Oakland Grizzlies playing tonight against Michigan State here in East Lansing. Then they'll bus to the airport and fly out early tomorrow morning to Tucson to face number 3 Arizona Tuesday night. Then against Pitt on ESPN3 on Saturday. Clemson on December 22nd prior to Christmas on E3, and then over at Maryland, and then finally to league play, and finally to a home game, the first one in almost a month. And for the Spartans, this is a busy homestand. Eastern Michigan, which has been surprisingly good the non-conference year, having already upset Michigan. Then Texas Southern on the U on Saturday, the Citadel, and Maryland. Conference play begins on the 30th, Indiana to follow, so Michigan State will face Maryland for the first time in league play ever.
You know, it's incredible, though, for Tom Izzo's bunch. This is only their fourth home game the whole season already, and there are a number of teams that are getting close to double digits in home games. He plays anywhere, anytime, and I was kidding Greg Campy. I said, do you not like your kids or what? What are you doing? Five games, including this one, that stretch we just looked at, all on the road, but both coaches have it part of their big picture philosophy.
I like the fact, too, I mentioned this earlier, Bob, both of them have stayed a long period of time at their respective universities, and Campy says, I believe the reason for that, in part, is the fact that we just love this state, and it's just hard to find a way to move. We don't want to go.
My brother Jim used to have a great saying, don't mess with happy. And both these guys seem very happy, and their schools seem very happy with them, so why upset the apple cart?
Clark on the steal.
Oh, my.
Nasty.
Just so good when they get an opportunity off a steal, off a miss. They are flying, and Clark with a terrific job there overplaying the passing lane, turning it into an easy one.
Difference in this game is 19 points. The edge in fast break points, 23-5. Petros with a turnaround hook. And for Corey Petros, he now has 11 to go along with 8 rebounds, couple of assists.
That's his go-to move. Catch it and go over his left shoulder.
He has been limited, however, to playing minutes tonight simply because of foul difficulty, because he has 4.
Anticipation there, Clark. They get in the open court. They are all going to be able to finish. Some very talented freshman. What a nice blend of size, experience, perimeter shooting, interior play, ball handling. Nice pass by Tum Tum.
He gets the assist, and Denzel Valentine, he gets his 4th made 3, is not missed with the home run tonight. Michigan State back up by 20.
It's interesting about this team. Again, over that left shoulder. That's a dynamite move by Petros. This Michigan State team has good chemistry, but Tom Izzo said they had good chemistry last year. What they have this year, though, is more leadership. Sometimes we use those interchangeably, and they're not. The SGS team got along. They wanted to share the ball. They were good passers, but they didn't have that vocal leadership that you want to the extent that this year's team does. Those guys are stepping up and bringing it, most notably Trice. Certainly he and even Valentine have done that. Dawson is less vocal, but he is kind of leads by his effort. And they've gotten the kind of leadership that he really wants to see.
When you were coaching, Bob, would you prefer to have good chemistry or somebody or somebodies that would take charge of the team, particularly when things weren't going well?
Well, I think that's the whole point. I don't think they're mutually exclusive, but they are different things. If I had to have one or the other, and I think you want to have chemistry. If you don't have good chemistry, it creates all sorts of problems with playing time, sharing the ball. Guys don't trust each other. They don't want to pass it because they don't think they're going to get it back. You don't really trust making a defensive play because you don't think anybody's going to cover for you. So chemistry is huge, but you know that you can be good with chemistry. To be great, you better have leadership too.
Well, it was off camera, but both Campy and Izzo had a light-hearted moment there. Both had smiles on their face. Of course, I think Tom feels a little bit better about the effort tonight. His team is up by 20. And Valentine's first miss.
He thought he made it. He was already backpedaling.
Back the other way, Khalil Felder really struggled in the first half and the entire game to shoot it. Just 3 of 11 now, but that's a made three. And a blocking foul coming up at 9:22 remaining in our game. Game you may have seen earlier tonight on the U between North Carolina, Wilmington, and Louisville. Louisville was up huge in the second half by 18. And UNC Wilmington got within two before the Cardinals won it.
So you never get too comfortable in this game, especially with a team that likes to shoot it behind the three-point line. Oakland averaging just under 9 threes a game. They've already got 5 here tonight.
Marvin Clark can nail this too. It would be 5 in double figures. Team foul situation, Oakland well over the limit now with 8, Michigan State with 5.
Went on Schilling on the rebound. You know, Jay Wright said it best in New York at the Jimmy V. If you're, you know, one of the good coaches in this game, of which there's so many, your team's going to get better. Shot goes around and out that time for Weaver. But the question is, obviously, you know, who's going to get better the most? And more importantly, who's going to address whatever things they are weak at right now? And if you assume that some teams are, boy, you've seen a lot of good teams early. Villanova's off to a great start. This Michigan State team's off to a great start. Louisville's, this Kentucky's playing lights out. So, you know, I don't think you can come to any kind of conclusions this early.
You saw Villanova at the Garden. I saw them in Philadelphia on their home court against St. Joan, a game where they just ran and hid.
Yeah, I mean, you know, that's why I say seeing teams this good look this good early is now we've turned this thing into a shootout.
It's the fourth game, by the way, this year for Michigan State in which the Spartans have knocked down 10 threes.
They're not done yet.
No, sir. Looks sharp and very crisp with their passing tonight.
Again, look at the spacing, how quickly the ball moves. They really explore every option off that break, and then they have the good composure to get it out, balance the floor, and run their set.
Oh, Schilling above everybody.
That was a spectacular rebound. He's been playing much better as well. Had his first career double-double earlier in the year against Santa Clara, and he's tied for first in the Big Ten in field goal percentage.
And he's got 5 rebounds tonight. Grizzlies, despite being down by 22, will not stop doing what they think they can do the best, and that is knock down to 3. But tonight, Oakland just 4 of 17 from the arc. We are approaching 7 minutes for the game.
And with that, we have a television timeout. Let's step aside. Back to business here in East Lansing, Michigan. Bob Valvano, Jim Barber. UConn and Duke, a rivalry renewed this year. Undefeated Duke. Title contenders, you know that. But the defending champion Huskies will shoot for an upset. Journey to the Tourney presented by Sonic. Part of Holiday Hoops presented by K Jewelers Thursday at 8 on ESPN. UConn has won 4 of the last 5 against Duke. Meanwhile, back here, Denzel Valentine brought a shooting touch to the game.
Yeah, he really can make a defense have to spread out. This one, a hustle play, saves it from going out of bounds in the corner. A lot of these are simple catch and shoots. Here's a nice one going to his left off the dribble, squares up, and it's right in the bottom of the well. An impressive evening for Valentine. Not only, look at that, 19 points, but 4 assists as well. He's thrown in 3 rebounds and a steal to boot, and just 1 turnover, taking care of the basketball. Michigan State only has 6 turnovers on the night.
And 22 assisted baskets of the 29 made field goals. And if you're just tuning in, welcome aboard here during this holiday season. Spartans have 5 players in double figures. After the game was tied at 20-20, busted out to a 13-point first half lead at the break, and have expanded that lead. Oakland led in scoring by Dante Williams with 13, Corey Petros with 13. And before this fast break, you get the crowd rising. Foul called in the backcourt.
Perfect example there, as good as Felder is, and how we talk about he stuffs the stat sheet in so many different ways. Look at the difference in Oakland's break tonight. Over-penetrated, the spacing hasn't been there. Michigan State's come down, great spacing, ball gets knocked one side, other side, ball reversal. It's credit Michigan State's defense for that, but still. I think Oakland's break has not been as effective as they'd like it to be tonight.
And you mentioned Tum Tum, his first point of the night just seconds ago. So he's right about at his average. 5 assists in 15 minutes.
The only thing he's not been doing is shooting the ball. But he has been making his teammates better. Great energy, great attitude, Tom Izzo says. And a cool name.
Very cool. Grandfather picked it out. Big fan of Lou Rawls. Mom's name is Mona Lisa.
Not getting shortchanged in the name department.
No, sir. And the Tum Tum comes from the fact that Mom was a big fan of the movie The Three Ninjas and a character in their name, Tum Tum, that liked to eat all the time.
Not Petro's forte here, just a 43% free throw shooter.
And frankly, he's better than that. He was better than that last year, and he's going to get a lot of opportunities in the Horizon League. Tonight he is 1-for-5 and has not looked good at the line. This is the second of a 6-year renewal contract between the two schools.
Look at that ball move.
Ellis gets the spot up for a 3, and look at the rebound. Now Oakland with a rare fast break, led by Felder. And Khalil Felder will the line. Second of 6 years, Oakland gets roughly $75,000 to play here in East Lansing each of the 3 games. And in return for the fact they have a home game at the Palace in the 3 of the 6 years against Michigan State. Campy School will pay Michigan State roughly 1.25, 125. And the thing Campy loves about the games at the Palace is the fact that you get 12, 13, 14,000 in the house. Granted, mostly Michigan State fans, but you get several thousand of your own fans in there, and it's a pretty good atmosphere. Brandon Dawson nails the short jumper. His mid-range game is pretty hard to stop.
6 field goals. So we said they have everything, really. They have a great perimeter game. They got guys who can beat you off the bounce. They got a mid-range game. They crashed the offensive glass. Their defense has been very, very good the last seven games.
About the only Achilles heel is the free throw shooting at 62%. That's going to be three shots coming up off the foul by Ellis.
Come on, ref!
Spartan ball on three. Alvin Ellis, his second.
Well, Greg Campy's a bit of a prophet because he told us before the game, if this game gets up in the mid-70s, we're going to have a hard time. They've already given up 75, and there's still more than 5 minutes to go. But again, they're in a league where in all likelihood it's going to be a one-bid league. It's about winning your league. And he uses this stretch of games to get his team as ready as can be to go into that conference. He did it before in the Summit, now trying to do it in the Horizon.
Well, last year they had a monster schedule to start the non-conference year. He was sharing that gauntlet with us prior to the game tonight. And he's a lot like Tom Izzo in that regard, the fact that both of them like to play heady competition early in the year to get a barometer as to where they stand. And in the Summit League, because of the fact that he played a lot of those tough teams, he didn't get a chance in the first round of the NCAA tournament to face somebody of some quality, and his guys weren't intimidated. Didn't typically win, but certainly were not afraid of the assignment.
Oh, that's nice. Dawson, game slows down when you get to be experienced. The senior made it look very easy there. It was not as simple as he made it look.
Felder, no-look pass, and I'm not sure Williams was looking either as that ball is turned over.
You know, we talked about, look at that, what you do by preparing for your conference in the state of Michigan. Oakland has the highest win percentage in league in the last eight seasons. Over 70% of their conference games were won over those last 8 years, so he obviously has a recipe, toughen them up early, and when you get the conference play, take care of business.
Makes them mythical state champs, right?
Beautiful execution there. Forbes coming off a screen, gets his fourth three-pointer of the night.
Forbes also well into double figures. He has missed only one field goal attempt. 25-point Michigan State lead. We are getting down to 4 minutes to go. Down to Petros, continue to play with four personal fouls. And Dawson fouled in the backcourt, and Oakland has reached 10 fouls. That means two shots coming up for the Spartans. Back with the final 4 minutes of this non-conference game tonight from the Breslin Center. Spartans headed to their seventh victory of the season, comfortably ahead with 3:57 to go. ESPNU brings you coverage of the NCAA Division III football championship. They meet again, like they did last year for the title game, Wisconsin, Whitewater, and Mount Union. NCAA Division III football championship is presented by Northwestern Mutual, Friday at 7 on the U, and watch ESPN. Last year, Whitewater thrashed Mount Union for the title, and Mount Union, which has suffered just one loss in the last couple of years, has not forgotten it. Should be a great revenge matchup Friday night in Salem.
Izzo has to feel pretty good about a lot of parts of this game. The numbers don't lie. Holding Oakland at 25% shooting behind the three-point line. This Oakland team is a team that shoots up around 37%, and his team 10 for 16 behind the three-point line.
And I mentioned it earlier, and it may seem a bit ticky-tack, but now 5 of 14 from the free-throw line, and you're going to have one and two possession games in the league and certainly in the tournament. How does that get remedied?
I promise you they practice them. I will say that.
I knew that.
That's going to be a bugaboo for this team perhaps all year.
So this is the first part of an extended road trip for the Oakland Grizzlies. Brandon Dawson, by the way, 2 points away from 1,000 for his career. Brent Forbes has already reached 1,000 in this game.
I don't believe they've ever had two players go over the 1,000-point career mark on the same night in this long, wonderful history of this program. So that would be a unique event tonight.
Saw one of the former head coaches here tonight, part of the radio broadcast crew with Will Tiemann, Duskanakis.
What a nice man.
Indeed. There's Keenan Wetzel. That's Bob's favorite player. He is a great scrimmage, a great practice player.
We watch him in practice, and without exaggeration, he'll make seven or eight threes in a row. It's just, I think, one of four on the season. He's a terrific. They need a guy on the other team, on the scout team, to be the shooter. He can play that role. No question.
Sure. Right now, he's about 30 feet from the goal. Eight to shoot, and Michigan State by 26. Great ball movement, got off a shot.
That's a sign, though. I mean, they're up 26. There's some guys who've had very few minutes. That's the time sometimes on other squads for let's go get yours. Instead, that was terrific ball movement right there. They got about three ball reversals, got it inside.
And for the night, 24 assists on 32 made baskets. That's 75% of assisted field goals. That's a real healthy number.
Big hand for Dawson as he goes out. So we'll have to wait another day to get that milestone. I think Greg Campy is going to be disappointed. I think he really did believe. They've given this team some tough games in the past. They shoot it very, very well. I think he really had thought they were going to be 5 minutes to go in a position to have a chance, and this thing got away from him in the middle part pretty dramatically.
Michigan State has shot 57% from the floor and from the arc even better on 10 of 16 for 62%. And you brought up a great point earlier. Oakland's three-point attempts challenged primarily during this game. Michigan State, many of those were not.
I don't think Greg Campy would be offended to say most people would perceive Michigan State to be the superior defensive team, but you got to think that you want to play defense at least well enough to give yourself a chance when you're a good offensive team, and he has a good offensive team. But not tonight. They couldn't stop them pretty much the whole ballgame.
And you don't have the athletes like Michigan State. In fact, joking before the game, Campy was looking, I believe at Dawson, said, just once I'd like to coach somebody like that.
Well, he makes a good point. You know, the perimeter players, as good as they are, and there's probably an edge across the board there, but there's some really good guards at the mid-major level. The difference is the size, the front court players, and just the strength and athleticism, it's tough to combat that. Now, this is a young man, Ellis, that Tom Izzo also said, you know, when, as they go forward and get better, he's a guy that he thinks they can work him into the rotation in meaningful ways as well. He hasn't had a game where he's played any more than 8 minutes because of an ankle injury early. But they think he can be a contributor as they go forward.
And this is a team that's been through injury and been through sickness, and of course they do the proverbial knock on wood when they talk health, but they feel that they're getting to a point where they're going to be fine with just about everybody involved, and get Bess out there as well. That's going to be huge.
As we mentioned earlier, Bess is really close to being able to play.
We think if Appling doesn't get hurt last year, maybe they're in the Final Four. Ooh. In fact, I think there's a little doubt there in the Final Four.
Again, the great ball movement. Yep, fake. And that gives a chance to go to the line for Trevor Bonhoff here.
2 minutes remaining in our game. Campy's team will have a short night tonight to rest up, and then from the airport tomorrow morning, an early morning flight to the west in Tucson, Arizona. So they're going to go from facing Michigan State to The Arizona Wildcats.
It's all good, Trevor.
Not a good place to go and try and get healthy. And after that, that two-letter word, at. A lot of ats there. At Pittsburgh, at Clemson, at Maryland. Tenth Spartan to score on the evening.
Arizona, huge winner yesterday over Michigan. Catch and shoot. Two-pointer. So Hooper with a fadeaway. He hails out of Carmel Valley, California. Wetzel's got a fan club behind us.
Yeah, they must have gone to practice because he can shoot at practice. A very aspiring TV producer, I'm told.
Open for the moment. Won't take the shot, and he'll drop it down. Tend to shoot it.
Oh, nice move inside by Williamson.
You always appreciate when the bench is standing and enjoying. Michigan State to run one of its many breaks in the game. Well, Wetzel still had a smile on his face.
He's had hard luck in the games. You'll have to take our word for it about practice.
he's automatic. 49 and 9-tenths of a second until we say goodbye.
It's all good, Wetzel.
Curious to hear from Tom Izzo what he's happier with, the good shooting percentage of his team or the ability to take away the open threes for this Oakland team, because they did both very well.
Defended Oakland into 5 of 20 tonight with just 25% on the three-point shot and overall field goal shooting just 37.
All likelihood be the last Michigan State possession. Tom was trying to set him up. Diving for loose balls with a 28-point lead.
Hey, I like to see that.
It's a way of life here.
Nice drive to the hoop.
Basket by 11, Nick Daniels.
And that'll do it.
Hell yeah, Tom.
Michigan State, woo! Most impressive tonight in knocking off Oakland. 87-61. We'll be back with more from here in East Lansing, but right now, as we exit the Breslin Center, let's send you back to the studio.